probably, the monsters which had been buried kept multiplying, and the numbers increased enough to make poison leak outside. Forte says, then if we get rid of them, the poison will stop leaking out. Luckily we have the resonance stone of purification. Let's kick their butts. Now. Giant poison bug. Okay. Kill this one, hopefully. Oh, I thought I selected the top one. Maybe it doesn't matter. Oh, it's still alive. Alright, one down. Alright. He wanted us to do it. I guess it still draws down his magic. Because he's missing a little magic point there. So even though the magic is in the stone, it draws off their mana. That's interesting. Did I do that right? Let me see. I think I did. Yeah. We hit this thing a couple times, I think? To clean your heart. Yeah. Purge one. It's poison again. Ah! Poison is spreading to other targets. Alright, well, you heal McBain. Una will use the potion on Jan. McBain will attack. Oh, we need to use her finishing move next time. Yeah, we would have got a chance this time. Sweet. Missed. Good. Damn. Alright, one left. Oh, can't reach him. Alright, so attack. I'm gonna use her use her finishing move. McBain's just gonna purify himself. Shining arrow. Can we just kill it instead? Sweet. This is definitely the most polished of the games with the different gameplay. The ending screen and like the combat end screen is pretty awesome. Forte says, phew, we hardly succeeded in defeating them. You mean you barely succeeded. McBain says, yeah, at least we were able to kill the basic poisonous monsters. I think the poison will stop leaking out. Good work, Forte, says Una. Forte says, yeah, since we're done with our mission here, let's go back up. Alright, so we've been going this long. I would cut it off here, but that's a pretty long episode, so let's just keep going and split it in two, perhaps. But first, a little healing here. The petal cure has been used up. Oop, can't go that way. Okay, we'll fight you. But you twisted my arm here. We need a healing resonance stone. I guess that would be the life stone. Yeah, no spoilers. I'm just musing here. Do not confirm or deny, please. Oh, God. I don't even know which one's which. Just kill him. I forgot which way we were going. This way? No? Right. Okay. I know this is the way out. Slamming the door. Alright, so now we have to get back up and have him close the waterway so we can get back up, and they can have water again. I love the way he bounds up the stairs, like, hmm? Forte says, we defeated the monsters underground. McBain says, I don't think poison will leak out anymore. That's cool. Good work, guys. Were you able to find what you were looking for? Yes, thanks to you, McBain says. Good for you. Thank you for your work. Why don't you come up here? I'm going to open the water gate. We are already up here. I mean, over here? Alright then, I'm going to open the water gate. Yeah, you keep saying that. Good. By the way, what were you looking for? Can I see it? McBain took out a resonance stone. This is what we were looking for. I see. This one, huh? It's called a resonance stone. This is something like a lucky charm for a performer. It's a little better than that. Torso says, well, it's good that poison stopped leaking out, and more than anything, I'm glad that you guys came back alive. If something had happened to you, I would have felt responsible. Please let Elder know that the poison stopped leaking. I'm sure he's very worried. Please perform for us next time you come. Sure thing, McBain says. We'll put on a great show for you guys. You're such a people pleaser, Dorso says. Alright. Nothing in here. We've already looked at that fishy. Here. Yeah, okay. Just making sure there's been no additions that he's made while we were gone. See you later. Go check back into town. Phew! I'm so glad that poison problem is over. Mr. McBain and the company are people of merit, right? Hee 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 hee, McBain says. What's wrong with you? Forte says, ha ha, never mind. Something good happened to him. Una says, it's not that he went nuts. He is nuts enough, Seiha says. He's still laughing.
Did you go underground? Old people aren't afraid of anything.
You either, says McBean. It probably won't let us leave. Let me just see. Oh, wow. Okay. I wanted to see if one of those little lines came up. I'd be like, are you out of your mind? We have to do this thing. Forte, Mr. McBean, thank you for getting rid of the monsters. By the way, did what I told you help you to find what you're looking for?
Yes, very much, McBean says. Thank you. Thanks to you, we were able to find it.
McBean took out the resonance stone and showed it. McBean says... Okay, this is supposed to be Barappa then talking. So this is what you were looking for. You mean this? Says Barappa. I don't know who is supposed to be saying that. Stop. It's called a resonance stone, says McBean. It's like a lucky charm for musicians. You're right. Staff notation is engraved on it. Glad you could find what you're looking for. Thanks a lot. Yeah, that confused me a little bit. He's saying the Barappa, so this is what she was looking for. And then she says, yeah, this is it. I guess the both of the portraits were, like, mixed up or something. Oh, I can't go past that thing.
Mr. McBean, I heard that Forte is entered to perform in the recital in Pinsel. How's he doing?
Well, he needs a little more practice. It's not easy to win the competition.
I'll cheer for you at the recital in Pinsel. Good luck, Forte.
Thanks.
I heard you defeated poisonous monsters. Way to go, Mac.
He's laughing again. Okuru says, you look happy. Did something good happen?
I'm not gonna tell you, McBean says.
Never mind. My grandpa's acting weird lately.
Forte and his friends wiped out the monsters. Only McBean's grandson could do that.
Okay, why is she saying that to Forte and his friends?
So, Mr. McBean, you defeated the monsters. You're so cool. You're not only a good musician, but also a good fighter.
I just don't want to miss anybody. I talked to her. He's the elder, right? I'll talk to him last anyway, even though there is not an exclamation mark over his head.
Listen, Forte. Hector's daughter, Nereith, was all fired up about starting your fan club.
A fan club?
The recital in Pinsel is coming up soon. This means you're big debut on the big stage. I can't talk. Forte has no reaction to that. He's like, oh, fan club? Okay, cool. Later he'll be like, what? They have a fan club of me? Look, there goes old Mac, Forte, and Una. Hello, Gina, Forte says. McBain says, don't call me old, please. I just went there. Wasn't there an area with the two old ladies in it, but... or the two old people. I might be thinking of back home. There was one area we could only get to by crossing one bridge and then another. I know I tried to keep that in mind, but... like, it's like you have to go like that or something. Well, I've already talked to her. I think we talked to everybody. Just seems like more houses than I thought. Let me just take a peek over here. Oh. Okay. This one, right. I knew there was one other house. They're not old ladies, though. Forte, Grandpa McBean, thank you for defeating the monsters. By the way, did you find what you were looking for? Yeah, says Forte. Treasure hunting is one thing, but don't forget to practice for the recital. Nevith's been nagging too much about it every day. Forte, are you practicing? Don't be too confident to skip practicing. I know. Thank you for pumping me up, says McBean. Una says, I'll make sure he'll practice. Okay. Well, that's what I wanted to do. I knew there was one house. I will go talk to the elder. It's not this way. Oh, I'm, like, above the stage. Is that the other way? Hi.
I'm happy we could stop it before it became serious. Mac, you saved me again.
Again? Says Una. What are you talking about? Says McBean. Una says, look, Grandpa Mac is being humble for a change. I don't think so, says Forte. Grandpa helps others, but he helps others to fulfill his own purpose so he doesn't always know he's helping others. That hurts, says McBean. See? Says Forte. Una says, anyway, poison is not going to flow out anymore, and we found the resonance stone. We had a happy ending. Yep, game's over. Thanks for watching, guys. Let's go back to Reiko's Palma, then, McBean says.
Anyhow, I thank you. Thanks to you, the water mill keeps spinning like this.
Like your eyes? He was saying before, his eyes spin, too.
So he's going back to town now. McBain says, "It's a feel-good place here." "Yo-hee-ho," says Burrell. McBain says, "You guys work really hard." Burrell says, "The rinsing part is very important for good fabric, so it's worth doing this." "Yo-hee-ho." Syl says, "Look at this fabric. It is dyed with dye stuff you guys delivered the other day." "Really?" says Forte. Una says, "I'm somehow deeply moved by that." "Oh, look at the coloring," says McBain. Burrell says, "Hee-hee, isn't it beautiful?" McBain says, "Krenka's fabrics are famous in the world. They're even traded in the Far West Ostern." "Cool," says Una. Syl says, "Krenka's weave fabric is good too, but the secret of their popularity is due to the dye stuff of Reiko's Palma." Forte says, "Reiko's Palma is pretty cool then." "This is a good place to play in the river." Una says, "The water flows smoothly." "Oh no." McBain says, "I've started to feel like taking a nap." Jan yawns. "Huh. Well, we're not napping. We're going back." Syl says, "Hey, Mr. McBain, it looks like you're in a good mood." "Yes, I am." "Anything good?" Burrell says. "Yeah. Hee hee hee." Forte says, "Just ignore him. He's a little weird lately." "It's good to be in a good mood," Syl says. "I'm happy for him." McBain goes, or something? "See you later," Una says. "Bye," Burrell says. Burrell, whatever. Okay. Time to head back home. Completely sure where I'm going, but this must be the way. Monstre! Get that monkey. That funky monkey. Tiny bit. Trying to save him, but potions, I mean. I don't want him to actually attack the monkey. Oh, I forgot to hit the... Well, I'm afraid they're gonna hit the... He's gonna go after the monkey. I want him to hit the other thing. Doesn't matter now anyway, I killed it. Alright, we need to heal Una, so... Cure bottle S. Yeah, I don't know if there's a place to rest in Kranka. I don't think so. Kind of surprised about it, though. Monkey, monkey! Might as well use it. Just advancing. They're so close to leveling up. Is Forte and Una are. Maybe this will level them up. Rock crash. And then there was one. And like a fool, it didn't lose morale and run away. Nice. Forte level 4 and Jan. Jan has learned Pero Pero Cure. Oh, okay, he's got another doggy healing spot. We got another Purify Potion. As if we need any of those. Wait. Deals a moderate amount of damage for a single character. Sweet. Man, this is a good dog to have. A dog that can heal you? Here we go. She'll just kill them both right now. My god, 1 point. I will reload the level just to get her that 1 point. Here we go. That will not be necessary, and the enemy has surprised us. Wait. Doesn't actually make that much sense. Okay. You hit that one. You hit that one. You hit that one. And the dog will try to use a finishing move on this thing. awesome. Luna! Level 4! Now they're level 4. They caught up with McBean. Took him all his life to get to level 4, and they're still kids and they got it. For McBean. Well, I'm out of power. I'll just want to focus on this thing. Except for the dog here, Meech. Maybe. It was on the edge. Woof. Now, if I think I would press the other button, they hurry up, right? I'm not sure. Okay, the bottom button is a speed up. Okay. They run across like that when you... He's just sitting here all innocent-like. And then we go mess up his day. Yeah, I'm speeding them up. It doesn't speed up the weight. No, they still wait. Maybe it does. I'm holding it. Oh. I'm gonna hold it down, see what happens. I'm probably just gonna kill that thing now. Yeah. Alright. It seems to speed up small bits at a time. McBean says, we successfully obtained a resonance stone in Krenka. Let's see, Forte. Do you want me to give you a lesson on a Kithara? Really? He says. Can you really? It would be my honor to get a lesson from you, Grandpa. After all, you're so kind, Grandpa. Ahem. It wouldn't be good if my grandson wasn't able to win a prize in the recital. You're blushing, Grandpa, says Una. McBean coughs. Let's get your practice going by the lighthouse. Yes, sir, says Forte. Oh, just automatically there, okay. Playing the instrument is not merely playing the stuff on the musical scores. You have to convey the feeling that the music has. You need to express the emotions with your whole body. Yes, sir. McBean says, you can still improve, but you're getting much better. Thank you, Grandpa. What do you think? It's important to practice over and over by yourself, but you can learn different things when you learn from someone. Yes. Grandpa, now that you know that the map is a real magic map for sure, are you going on a trip? Yes, I made up my mind. I'll leave after watching your performance at the Pinzel recital. This trip is my last chance. Anyway, why don't you play one more time? Yes, sir. Surprised we're not actually hearing him playing. Thanks to McBean's advice, Forte remarkably improved his skill. That night, McBean kept company with Forte to practice the Kithara. McBean says, ugh. Who's that? Oh, that's Forte down on the bottom with his parents. Okay. Forte's father says, I see. Grandpa told you that, huh? The mother says, if he's that serious, I don't think we can stop him. What should we do? Asks Forte. Well, the father says. The mother says, I have an idea. Let's have Forte come along with him. What? Forte says, why? If he goes alone, I would be worried. But if you go with him, that will put me at ease a little. No way. The father says, yeah, that's a good idea. I feel better about it, too. Why me? Because you guys get along so well with each other. Does that matter? Yes, the mother says. It's very important. The father says, yes, of course. Wait a minute. Just hear me out, okay? K- can you wait to make the final decision until the Pinzo recital's over? It never occurred to me that I might go on a trip with him. The father says, well, if you say so, I'll give you some time to think about it until the recital is over. The mother says, it's getting late. Why don't you go to bed? Good night. Good night. I had no idea another cutscene was about to happen. I didn't know we were right outside the gate. Otherwise, I would have stopped right before. That's okay, though. Una says, Dad, Mom, what is it, Una? Her father says. And the mother says, what? What if I say I want to go on a trip? What would you do? You want to go on a trip? The mother asks. Well, I haven't really decided yet. Her father says, why all of a sudden? Isn't it a bit dangerous for a girl? It's a girl's intuition telling me. What is that? Mother says, it must be about Forte. You're going to go anyway, even though we try to stop you, right? Yeah, I think so. We'll be worried, but as they say, if you love your child, let them go on a journey, right? Who says that? I never heard that. I think it's okay. The father says, hey, what are you saying? Una, you're as stubborn as your father, even though you don't look it. Honey, you're the one who's stubborn, even though you don't look it. No, you are. No, you are. Oh no, it's you.